before I forget, I just want to ask you, I want to digress a little bit from the playoffs and go to the Toronto Maple Leafs, where they did two major signings. One was very predictable for me, but the other one was a little bit of a surprise. Joffrey Lupo was a surprise to me.
Joffrey Lupo?
I did.
He wasn't. It was Kadri.
Kadri. Sorry. Kadri was a surprise to me. Sorry, Kadri.
Well, Kadri represents a number of things with the Leafs. He's the only player on the team that will defend himself. He represents the Maple Leafs. He's the personality of the Maple Leafs. The Maple Leafs are a nondescript team right now, and I think they need Kadri's presence. They signed him as a second-line centerman, and that was a perfect signing. I think they did a good job on him. Riley, I don't know how good he's going to be.
I predicted that they were going to sign Riley. They see something in him. He's young. It could be a mistake, or it could be brilliant.
Yes, it could. 6-year deal could be brilliant. I don't disagree, Frank. I think he's still out there as to how good he's going to be.
But it was predictable that the Leafs were going to rope him down. They liked him. Everything I've read about the relationship between the Leafs and this guy was that they were gonna, you know, I did, Kadri had a lot of issues. They say he's a bit of a rebel, you know, but I like him. I've always liked him, but you know, sometimes the coach really has to deal with him.
Well, the coach, it's his favorite. Babcock's favorite player.
They got along, but Babcock, I heard, read him the riot act when he came in.
Oh, yes, he did. He did. He had to change. I mean, he was irresponsible, disrespectful. He was a slob. He was a punk.
I did not expect Kadri. I told you guys last year that I didn't mind him, but he had this complete disregard for respect of his peers.